With 10 layers in one giant mouthful, jawbreakers are famous for needing a lot of suck. And for being so hard that biting one could leave you a big dentistry bill. First hitting the sweet scene in the mid-19th century, jawbreakers quickly became the tough guy in town. And these mouth-bulging morsels are made here at Oak Leaf and Sweetworks in Toronto, Ontario. Every jawbreaker begins with a candy centre, and that is where Richard comes in. He's been making them for 12 years, and he still can't beat them.
I try to buy it. I'm buying it and see how I can finish it. If I cannot finish it, I use a hammer. Use a hammer and break it, and so I can finish it in half an hour.
Well, that's one way to do it, Richard. First, tumble blocks are placed into a panner. These weights help to ensure a smooth mix. Richard adds dextrose, which is a simple sugar, with colour, flavour and fruit acids. Fruit acids give the jawbreakers their sour tang. The mix is tumbled together for 10 minutes. And when Richard next comes knocking, it's time for the mix to take shape. He pulls the powder to a pill press. The mixture is poured into a hopper and is gravity-fed into a mold. A piston compresses the powder to create the round jawbreaker centre. Sweetworks produces nearly 2,000 centres per minute. Just look at them go. Next, Richard carts the centres to an engrossing room. Here, multiple layers of colour and flavour are added. The candy is then left in the hands of Hung Q, a man of few words, with good reason. The engrossing room is so loud, it's like standing near a jet engine.
Jawbreakers are one of the loudest products that we make. Being inside the pan room while jawbreakers are being made, it kind of makes you want to run out of the pan room.
Almost 500 kilograms of centers are placed in a panner. Nearly a liter of syrup is added, and they're spun to ensure an even coating. Dextrose powder follows. These ingredients are used to build up all the layers. Each layer takes 2 hours. The candy must harden before the next layer is added. The panning room is where they grow the balls bigger. Isn't that right, Stacy?
So we start out with 1,080 pounds of jawbreaker center, and after all the coatings, we end up with 9,000 pounds.
Super size those spheres. Each layer has a distinct color and taste. The next layer is cherry. Every other layer is white to mark the change in flavor. Next up is lime, followed by white. Blueberry, white again, and lemon. Two more coats of white are added to finish the layering process. Layers on layers on layers. This sweet would make an onion weep. But we're not finished yet. An edible glaze is ladled in to seal all 10 layers. Sweetworks makes 6,300 kilograms of jawbreakers every day. And for a final flourish, droplets of colour are added by spray bottle. Colour spreads across the white surface of the jawbreakers. A panning machine slowly rotates, giving the candy a speckled look.